Okay, friends, subscribers, and all of you YouTubers out there, man, have I found the evidence that all of you want to see. And in about 5 minutes, I'm going to be starting a Uber conference. So that once I put the information out there, that you can all have your say, because I'll tell you now, you are going to be so fucking pissed off that it's beyond a joke. But first of all, I'm going to let you know that this is their actual website, because they planned this, and when they planned it, they left a bit of critical information inside. And yeah, and it's the smoking fucking gun they left. I can't believe it. And it connects it to this virus. It connects it directly to this fucking virus. They really did fucking plan COVID-19. They fucking planned it. And I've got the fucking evidence from their own website, and I'm going to show you the evidence directly today or tonight, wherever you are watching. I'm going to put this up as a video as well. So if I'm responding to comments within the video, you're all going to have to just bear with me a little bit. Now, I found the evidence through their resources page and everything like that, because there's always hidden things within a website. There's always hidden things within a website. So what I did, I spent the fucking night, as you can see by the computer, I spent the fucking night going through this, and this is their website. This is the website for centerforhealthsecurity.org. It's got something to, and it's the John Hopkins Bloomberg School of Public Health is where it was held. The meeting was held on the 18th of October 2019 at 8:45 to 12:30 p.m. at the Pierce Hotel, New York. So it wasn't actually held at the John Hopkins Public Health, Bloomberg School of Public Health. Now, Bloomberg is one of the news channels, and the World Economic Forum, and Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Now, the World Economic Forum is, as everybody knows, is a bunch of elites. The elite, the top elites. And they even list their players within the thing. And it goes right through and it tells you everything. See, there's absolutely everything. So all I did, I just went to their About page and I noticed there were links. So the first link I clicked on was this one, and the scenario, and I went through. I haven't actually even clicked on this one, so I'm going to open this one up. And exercises, Claude, I'll open that one up. Dark window. Oh, actually, yeah. Oh, shit, there's going to be more. Oh, fuck. Anyway, this is not over, folks. This is not over. So then I started linking on everything. So this is a World Economic Forum, risk to global businesses from the era of epidemic rival change. And it takes you through and everything, and they're talking about it. And they go through, and I haven't actually investigated these three pages because I didn't get the link to these three pages, but you can tell there's their logo there. A pandemic, a latex. It's, they called it something else. And this one was, where are we? About, this one was in 2018, they planned this one, pandemic. So they've been actually planning this really since 2018. So they've actually really been planning it since they're saying it's an exercise. But see, the problem is they held the actual exercise and everything. So Dark Winter, this is the ones I've just found. Portrayed a functional scenario and key players, the Honourable Sam Numb, security advisor David Green. Mate, there's too many. There are far too many politicians. Now, see, this one, I believe, was the real exercise, right? In 2018 was the real exercise. Well, whether or not these people were part of it, but I believe that every single person named within these exercises should be investigated and their bank accounts should be investigated. Because these arseholes seriously planned this. And trust me, as you can see by all the little web pages at the top, there's a lot. So I've been reading my ass off, and I just happened to miss these links. I think I've missed a few, actually. But I got so excited when I found the smoking gun. And that was amazing. So, but I didn't know they actually had an exercise in 2018. The Atlantic Storm... conceived on January. So they're going back and back and back. So they have had exercises. And yes, I do believe they have exercises because I was part of the emergency services myself once. And yes, they do have exercises. But the thing is, for this to happen within days, for the virus to first start within days, and the fact that 5 million people left Wuhan around that period in late October, and some even before, 184 of them tested positive. China knew about this. Now, how do I know China knew about this? So we've got to find out about that. We've got to go to the players. So, and it's going right through this. Oh, there's another. Oh, no, that's just the event 201. And it goes through everything. All the documents. You've got to click on every link. You really do. And so I went through and I'm looking at all this. And I haven't read every page word for word because I just opened them up and I was just clicking through and seeing what evidence I actually had. So there's most probably even more connections within these documents, which I'm going to spend the day doing. So what I was doing, I was going through these people, because these people that I'm going to meet, Latoa D. Abbott, I reckon she definitely should be investigated. 100% needs to be investigated. And then this guy, or this lady, Sophia Borgs, Brad Cornett, Chris Elias, Timothy Grant Evans, George Fugo. Now, get this. This, as I said, I've been saying in the last video, the Chinese were at the table, because this guy's been on the news. And why has he been on the news? Because Professor George F. Gale is Director General of the Chinese Center for Disease Control and Prevention, a professor in the Institute of Microbiology, Chinese Academic Sciences, President of the Society of Biotechnology, and President of the Asian Federation of Biotechnology. Biotechnology. All right, not biology, biotechnology. Now, I've seen this guy on the news a fair bit over the last couple of months, and this is where it's going to start pissing everybody off. Because the further I went, I started just reading little bits, and okay, this lady needs to be investigated. And Scott Morrison, you need to investigate this lady. Jane Halton. Jane Halton is a member of the board of ANZ Bank here in Australia. And she needs to be investigated. Matthew Harrington needs to be investigated. Another Australian company. But these people are the elites. They are the elites of the fucking world, the tech giants or the banks. The ones that haven't taken a hit. The ones that have not taken a hit during this virus. And I am so glad Rachel got on my back, because a couple of weeks ago, a friend of mine, Rachel Reinstra, a very, very smart lady, great comedian, great actor, sort of mentioned it. And I said, yeah, I've heard of it. And but I hadn't actually fully researched it. Then in the last stream I did with her, she said, Tony, you need to look at this and everything. So I went and I looked at it. And I looked at it in-depthly. And after just watching the videos, I knew they had planned it. I knew just by watching the videos. Because there's too many fucking similarities in those videos. Too many. There's far too many fucking similarities. And all these people, I'm not going to mention them all, but every single one of these people need to be fucking investigated. Every single one of them. Every single person that was at that fucking table needs to be investigated. So then I'm going through and I'm looking at the finance and the World Bank. World Bank Group Pandemic Emergency Funding Facility. Now, when the World Bank gives countries money, the countries have got to pay them back. And why is my mic not working? Okay, no, it is working. So then I'm looking at that and I'm looking, okay, shit. See, this is how the World Bank, and now everybody know who owns the fucking World Bank. The elite, the fucking elite own the World Bank. Then I went to this one, okay, the Event 201 simulates an outbreak, a novel zoonotomic coronavirus transmitted from, get this, from bats to pigs. See, in the videos, they're only saying pigs. They left out bats. But here in the documents, in the scenario, in the Event 201 scenario, they're saying it goes from bats to pigs. And they see they blame the virus on pigs in the last video. Not bats. They deliberately, in their videos, they left bats out of the equation altogether so they could hide the fact and the connection to the coronavirus. So you really need to spend a couple of days on this website, folks. You really fucking do. But then I came across the next one. I'm looking at medical countermeasures, and they're talking about vaccine development. That's where Bill Gates comes into it. And then I thought, okay, I'm looking at this one. The Event 201 model. Here is the smoking gun. This is the link. And I'm going to enlarge this up so everybody can fucking read it. Oh man, this is fucking pissing me off something shocking, folks. And I'll just move this. Hang on, I'll move it so everybody can read it. Oops, no, I've gone too big. Hang on, I'll shrink it down. Give me a light. This is the smoking gun evidence. Now, this was prepared by Caitlin Rivers on October 11, 2019, before the meeting, right? Everything else within this site, in the videos, they hide the fact that of the connection to COVID-19. Now, I don't know if anybody can read the disclaimer. You need to read the disclaimer. I'm going to read it for you. And this is the smoking fucking gun. They left it in there. But now, get this, it's written in October 2019. And it's on the event model. Now, you've got to go through and find the links to it. It's on one of the pages. It will say event model, 201 model. This model was used exclusively for the exercise in October 2019 and does not relate and cannot be applied to the current 219 NCOV outbreaks because epidemiology inputs in this model differ from what is observed in 219 NCOV. Now, this is written before the fucking virus came out. So how do they fucking know? How the fuck are they making this disclaimer? This is written on October fucking 11, 2019. October 11, 2019. You can see it there with your own fucking eyes. And this is the Center for Health Security.org. All right. Bloomberg Group, Bill Gates Foundation, and the other mob. All connected to the WHO. They're all connected. They're all connected to the press, which we're feeding as bullshit. But this model was exclusively used for the exercise in October 2019 and does not relate and cannot be applied to the current 219 COVID outbreaks. It's written before the fucking outbreaks. It's written before the smoking gun, their own fucking evidence right before your fucking eyes. I will leave a link to this in the top of the description. I'm just going to copy it now, and it's going into the chat. So everybody go there, copy this page, save this page, save the page. Don't just bookmark it, save it. Everybody needs to save this page because they're most probably going to try and remove it. I wouldn't be surprised if they try and remove the video later. So the link has now been posted within the description as well, folks. So, but yeah, folks, it was planned. A guarantee, and there's their own fucking evidence right in front of you. And it's going to stay on the screen for the rest of this chat. Why? Because you, the people, deserve the right to know the truth. This is their own website. Yes, they've done exercises before because every emergency service does exercises. But the fact that this page was written on October 11, 2019, it's dated. They dated it. They dated the fucking thing. They can't deny this, folks. They cannot deny. They cannot fucking deny that this, no evidence, it was anything but an accident, Iran, not China. The suicide, okay. But, yeah, it's on their own fucking website. Hang on, what's this one? Okay. Sorry, DJ, it's not going to let you put it. Yeah. The YouTube fucking, yeah, you got to watch with your comments, DJ. You mention those words, mate, and YouTube will block you, not me. I can't even restore it. So yeah, there's the evidence in front of you, folks. This is event 201. The evidence to it was written, and the smoking gun was written on October 11, 2019. Now, we did not get told about the virus until late January, early February. We got told about the virus. This is the reason that China covered it up. Now, as I said, China was at the table. China was at the table. And, yeah, and just before I go, I will actually show who he is again and everything like that. Because Yeah, I was having a real fucking bad day yesterday. It's sort of all my emails had been died for fucking 3 weeks. I hadn't had an email in my main accounts for over 3 weeks. And I had to spend nearly 2 hours fixing them. So I was sitting at the computer while I was fixing them, and you had to wait for the fucking passwords to come through and everything like that. And so I started doing what any researcher does. I started fucking researching. The evidence here is plain to see. The document was prepared by Catlin Rivers on October 11, 2019. So how in the fuck did they know there's going to be an outbreak of COVID-19? They've switched the name around, they've moved it around, they've put 219 in front of it instead of at the back of it. But it was planned. This was planned. Thank you so much, Rachel Reinstra. You are the smartest lady I have ever fucking met. You really are, darling. You really are. And you've got a sexy ass as well. But, yeah, I've got to throw that in, folks. She is a nice lady. She's actually a really, I consider Rachel Reinstra a friend. She is. She's a very beautiful lady. Very funny. And if it wasn't for Rachel, I wouldn't, most probably would still not have actually gone into this too much, because I was too much worried about the pandemic itself, and because of what happened to me. And I've actually, by the way, I actually found out yesterday, it was one of the reasons I had a bad day yesterday. I found out that a friend something went wrong. And so they're actually currently pretty crook, still in quarantine, but they've been diagnosed as actually having the virus. So they're in lockdown. They haven't even been taken, put in the hospital yet. They've just been told to stay in quarantine until further notice. If anything gets worse, then they've got to go to hospital. So so I didn't have a good day yesterday. That's why I started researching, and because I was at the computer. So I just sat here and just started going through all these pages. And as you can see, they're all there, and there's still links, as you saw. I found 3 links that I hadn't found, and each page leads you to more links. But there's slight little hints, and the best thing about it, see, the reason why you get smoking gun evidence, the reason why you get that smoking gun evidence is because of the simple fact that someone fucks up. Like this, like Catlin Rivers fucked up and put the date in there. So in other words, she's telling everybody that this in no way has any connection to the outbreaks that's happening, because she's saying that, okay, well, there's outbreaks happening in IE in China. They knew that there was outbreaks in China in October, so it must have been released before fucking October 11. So the outbreaks in China have now been proven that they did happen in October. Why? Because it's here in fucking writing. This is their own, this is the mob that fucking planned the pandemic. And China was part of it. China was fucking part of it. They changed the name in the videos. And yes, there's videos, folks. There are videos to... where's my mouse gone? There's videos to it. And you can find the videos. Well, it's the second one. So, and all you got to do is you go to their thing and you click on videos. But yes, you do have to click on a few links and everything like that, because I found it through the resources page. Oops, I'll come back to that. I can always come back to it. I found it through the resources page, and I'm going, okay. And fact sheet, communication in pandemic event two. Oh, okay, PDF. So I thought I'll fucking read them. But so I got to that, as I said, I got to that one, communication in a pandemic. And I got to that one. Oh shit, I must have, did I delete that? Oh, I fucking did too. I'm an idiot. Oh, I'm an absolute fucking idiot sometimes. Yeah, and that's the dog. The Professor, Director General of the Chinese Center for Disease Control. So, they are at the table, folks. And he's actually, I'm pretty sure he's part of the CCP, because I have seen him as a politician whenever the pollies are on, talking about it and everything like that. So I'll get that one up. I'll just move that, reopen it, so that that comes back onto the screen. And but yeah, the evidence is clearly in front of you, folks. And like, you go through the model description and everything like that, the global spread, and they're talking about South America, i.e. who's been heavily hit, and they go through the whole fucking lot. It's all there, folks. The evidence is right in front of your nose. And as I said, someone always fucks up. That's what I love about society. There's always one fucking person that doesn't do their job correctly, or is a whistleblower, and this is the way she blew the whistle. So, I don't know whether she deliberately did it. I don't know whether she just fucked up and turned around and, oh no, you don't have to, it's too late, it's been deleted. I don't know whether she deliberately did it, folks. I don't know whether it was an accident or whatever, but the problem is she put the date, and she's put, this model was used exclusively for exercise in October 2019 and does not relate to and cannot be applied to the current 2019 NCOVID outbreaks because of the epidemiology inputs in this model differ from what is observed in 2019 NCOVID. But see, the name's there. They left the name. She put the name in there, just moved it around as if, in other words, oh, they won't notice. They'll just think it's something else because I put it in a different order. But the fact is, it's there. It's fucking there. This is why I'm so sick of governments. This is why I'm so fucking sick of it. Because of the simple fact that these fucking elite have a habit of turning around and, hang on. Also on 11/15 was hiring quarantine program advisors in the All right, Buster just put something up. Thanks, Buster. I'll get it up now. We'll come back to that one. Advanced Knowledge CDC started hiring quarantine program managers last November to cover quarantine centers, California, Washington. Yeah, all right, well, the CDC is fucking involved in this as well. Mate, there's too many fucking people involved in it. But see, I can't say, because this is in November, the CDC knew about it. Well, here's the proof that the CDC knew about it. But are they part of it? Yeah. We don't know. Or it could be assisting planning and implementing program for preventing the importation of communicable diseases from abroad and spread diseases. See, that one, Buster, may not be proof, but yeah, it's something to look into. I'll have a good read of it and I'll mention that one. But see, this is what I want left on the screen. I want the smoking gun evidence for everybody to read for themselves, because the more people that read this themselves will realize that Event 201 model wasn't just a model. See, they've put it, this is what gets me. I can't work out whether it was accidental. And it might have been an accident where she fucked up. But she might have been a whistleblower. Because you got to remember that whistleblowers do exist. They're among them. They disagree with what's going on, so they somehow release the evidence that is needed to make the connection. So maybe Catelyn is a whistleblower, but I don't think she is, because I reckon she would have come forward if she was a whistleblower, because that's generally what I think. She just fucked up and she left the evidence in there. This is what I mean. Go to that link that I pasted into the chat, folks. And I haven't pasted it into the chat yet. I haven't hit send yet. Oh, really, really sorry, folks. There we go. It's in the chat. Go to that link and save the page. Save that page. The more of you that save the page, the more it will be protected. If it's on your computer, the evidence will never disappear. So, Buster, please save this page. Spooky Cat, please save this page. The more of us that save this page, the less chance they've got to cover it up. Because when it's on too many computers, they will never find it. And this is what we need to do. Because this is truly the smoking gun evidence, everybody. It truly is. And, I just can't fucking believe it. Here it is a week ago. I'm thinking, oh, yeah, it is a pandemic. Yeah, all right. But then when someone's telling me that... another one from Buster. Oh shit, Buster, you are doing your research. Fuck, thank you. Now you see why I made you a moderator, Buster. Okay, bombshell, Chinese. Oh, okay, humans are free. What website is this? This is where the Chinese government ran a drill or exercise on September 18th in Wuhan, where they simulated a response. Yeah. I don't think it was an exercise. But they might have. This might have been the exercise. Fuck me. Wow. I can't play the video, but I will watch it, Buster. Thank you. Yeah, so there you go, folks. China is running an exercise in September 18. So the evidence is slowly coming out, and this is what I mean. But the smoking gun evidence, folks, is there now, right in front of your eyes. They've put a disclaimer up. Oh, this model was used exclusively for the exercise in October 2019 and does not relate and cannot be applied to the current 2019 in COVID outbreaks because the epidemiology inputs in this model differ. See, all they did in the exercise, they said it came from Africa and came from pigs. Oh, fuck. If you're planning something, of course you're going to make it different. Of course you are. That's what people do. They don't want to make the connection until someone fucks up. They fucked up all right. They left the fucking evidence there for us. The evidence is there in front of your fucking eyes. And it's scary. It's scary. They really did do it. I knew they did it. I only had to watch the videos. And when I saw the fucking... They're talking about it and they're talking about the numbers. But when I saw the fucking... It was the mask shortage that got me. The mask and glove shortage that got me. Why? Because China's been buying these up. Because that's what a lot of people don't know. China's been buying the masks and gloves since before October. So, all right, we know China is definitely one of the main players. And we know that China is influencing the elite, making deals with the elite. Do you know, because I watched a video tonight where China has been influencing Wall Street elites, because it was the Wall Street elite that helped them get onto the stock market, and they've been doing it for years. And there've been so many of their Chinese companies have been removed from the NASDAQ and everything. Sorry, I've got to have a drink of water. My voice is going. As I said, I was on the phone for a while trying to get the email sorted out. But when someone fucks up and gives you the smoking gun, Yeah, the smoking gun. Hang on, I've got to put a text up on this. Hang on, folks, just give me a second. The smoking gun. So we're going to add a text. So we're going to add a text. Where the fuck is it? Text, smoking gun, smoking. Oh, I can always use this again. Smoking gun. Font below is the smoking gun. They wrote this. Well, no, not in, on. Fucking. I always forget to put that fucking spot. I don't. Right, yes. On. October 11, 2019. There we go. I wrote this disclaimer. Sorry, folks, I definitely can't talk while I'm typing. Oh, because I've got to think of what I'm fucking typing. So, yeah, the smoking gun is there. How did they know that the virus was out there if they were not in on it? There we go. That's it. So I'm going to add a few little things to it, so there we go. Oh shit, hang on, I'll leave that there. So, turn it off there, gotta find the fucking page. Alright, so hang on, I'm just gonna jump over to this one for a second. That is scene 4. There we go. I'm gonna find the scene 4, add text, add existing. Okay. Gonna have to change the colour. So sorry folks, I just gotta just add a few little filters while I'm at it. So add a scroll. Yes, and yeah, I just can't believe they fucked up. I love it when people fuck up, because when people fuck up, they give you the evidence themselves. And that's the fucking thing. They give it to you. They gave it to us. We actually have the evidence, folks. The evidence is right in amongst us. There we go. That's much better. That's fucking heaps better. So the smoking gun evidence, folks, is right there in front of your fucking eyes. And this is why we need whistleblowers. Whistleblowers should never be harmed. Whistleblowers are needed. High loyalty. Did I hear about the president of Tanzania? They sent some samples in for testing and they found a pawpaw and a goat. Yeah, I heard about that. Yeah. See, they might have been spiking fruit. These tourists that left Wuhan might have been deliberately spreading it. China is definitely involved, 100%. They are definitely responsible. Well, you look what China is fucking doing, by the way. You look what China is doing. They are fucking taking over the South China Sea. They're threatening us, everything. But Bill Gates is in on this because his foundation is in the meeting. He definitely should get taken before the courts. And like he said, oh yeah, well, we want you to take the virus, the vaccine and everything, because he's going to make money out of it. It's all about money for Bill Gates. I wouldn't trust this fucking vaccine if they fucking paid me to take the cunt. I really wouldn't. I truly would not. And it sort of it is quite scary, folks, that here we go, we actually have the evidence. We actually have the evidence in front of us, where they're saying they've got a disclaimer, and that it's hang on, I'll put that there so I can always come back to it. Yeah. So, but see, that's the actual test kits that were actually infected. This is how we found out that the test kits were pre-infected. The test kits themselves have been pre-infected. And it's scary, folks. It is scary. The evidence is here in front of us that this disclaimer was written in October 2011, 2019. So how in the fuck did they write this disclaimer? Oh, it's got nothing to do with the virus in 2009. Oh, it's got nothing to do with the outbreaks in 2019. No, I got nothing to do with it. Yeah, fucking oath. It's got everything to fucking do with it. And here's the fucking proof. This is where the link to this pandemic is. This one fucking disclaimer is the link to the pandemic. Because in their videos, they say, oh, they called it CAPS. They said it started in Africa. But it didn't. It started in fucking China. We know that. 5 million people traveled from Wuhan in the month of October. 5 million. 5 million Chinese traveled from Wuhan to all over the world. I reckon they deliberately spread it. You think about it. All they had to do was put it on a surface, let someone touch it. All they had to do was go into a restaurant, touch the plates, because waitresses pick up plates with their hands. They only had to touch a glass. The dishwasher picks up a glass, he gets it. They might have deliberately spread it. But China is definitely involved. China might have still planned this themselves and got these all these organisations, i.e. the where the fuck are we? They might have got the World Economic Forum. Oh yeah, well, World Economic Forum. That is the elite, the John Hopkins, Walt Bloomberg School of Public Health, Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. Fuck. This is planned, folks. It really is planned. Yes, they've run exercises before. They have run exercises before. But when you see the evidence dated before a so-called known case was out there, saying, and it's the disclaimer is the evidence, and she dates it, that proves, that is the fucking proof. That is the proof of it. Oh yeah, I know, it's got to be more than two. Do you know that there's 20 million people, phone accounts missing? There were 20 million phone accounts missing in China. They just don't exist anymore. They've been deleted. 20 million, Chariot. 20 million, not 2 million. 20 million. 20 fucking million phone accounts just vanished in China since October of last year. And, but to find the smoking gun. As I said, I was just cruising. I was just filling in time while I was fixing up my email accounts. And then I come across that one fucking page. Oh yeah, this is why. Oh, you do know that the WHO leader's a commie. There's evidence of it out there. And it's sort of, but this evidence needs to be spread, folks. Please share this video. Copy this webpage that, and I'll repost that webpage. Copy this web page and save it. Save this web page to your own computer. The evidence here needs to be saved. The evidence needs to be on every computer there can be, so they can't delete it. Because after they find my video out there, because, yeah, they generally won't find the streams, but when they find the fucking videos, yeah, they will eventually delete the evidence. They always do. So please, save that. Go to the link, copy the web page, and save it to your own computer. Please, save the evidence to your own computer, everybody. It needs to be saved, and it will be in the video. And when I will paste it in the description of the video, because the description will be exactly the same as this one. And we need to save this evidence, folks. We really, truly do need to save this evidence, because it's the smoking gun. There's always a smoking gun. This is how police capture murderers, because someone fucks up and forgets to, Oh, yeah, I know. This is what I said to you. China started hoarding the supplies before October. They had their Chinese companies, and this is something else I found out, that most Chinese businesses are actually, that are in other countries, are actually controlled by the CCP. Did you know in America and Australia, we can't investigate their companies because they claim that there are state secrets within the company? That is the proof that it is state run. Even down to the dollar store that you go into, all the thing. And it's sort of, if it wasn't for Rach Chariot, because like I'd heard about it and I thought, yeah, well, I'll get to that eventually. And everything, I had an idea what it was about, and I knew, because I generally get to everything that everybody does tell me. I had a rough idea that they had something to do with it, and they had something to do with it. But then she said, no, Tony, you've got to watch the videos. And she played part of the video for me in the stream. And I thought, shit, I've got to go and do this. So I ended up spending 10 hours after I was on Rachel's show and watching all these videos. The videos are there, folks, so I'll go to the videos. I'll get the video page up. So all you have to do is you go to their videos, and there's six of them, folks. You've got to watch, because the, I'll see if I can stop. They acknowledge the Chinese dude, and you eventually see him sitting at the table. But this is why the Africans are being harassed in China, because they, I'd say the Chinese, there he is there. Oops, where is he? Yeah, there he is there. Shit. There he is there. This is how we know China's involved, through him. Because he's China's fucking disease control dude. But when you come across something like this, and as you can see, there's a lot of evidence, and I still haven't read it all, but I got to this one fucking page. This was what proved it to me. This is now 100% proof that this is a planned event, because of the simple fact . Would I start a revolution against government tyranny? Yes, I would. I'm trying to do it already, Chariot. I've joined a few Chinese websites, I've been doing a lot of writing. It's one of the reasons I haven't actually been streaming, but I'm not afraid of it. I've said it in my own videos that China needs to stand up to the CCP. And one of my other videos I'm going to be doing, I'm copying all of the old videos of the Chinese Revolution, so I can show the Chinese people what they have to do and what they did do to get rid of one tyrant king. Because at the moment they've got a new tyrant king and they just don't realize he's a king. And it's not this Contagion. It's not a, that's exactly what it was in the movie Contagion, from bats to pigs. Yeah, yeah. But see, in the in these videos though, in these videos, Chariot, they don't talk about bats. Bats left out of that meeting altogether. The word bat was left out of this meeting altogether. They just blame pigs. But it's within these documents, it says bats to pigs. And click on it, there's a link on a page. Sorry. I've spoken a lot. If you see links, click on links. Don't be afraid to click on a link. I.e., let's go to scenario, we'll click on link. So you click on a link. The scenario goes right through. Disease starts in a pig farm in Brazil and slowly first starts to spread more rapidly. It goes right through and people are getting sick and are in 80 to 90% of the global population has been exposed. Man, I've been talking too fucking long. I've been talking way too fucking long. But no, this is what you need. It's this fucking page. That's all you need, folks. This is all you need. Is this one fucking web page. Here is the smoking gun evidence. And unfortunately, there are Australians involved, there are Americans involved, but I believe they have been coerced and paid by the Chinese government. And I believe Bill Gates is part of this. Oh, I'm 100% fucking sure. Why do you think he wants us to take the vaccine? Personally, I think Bill Gates has already got the vaccine. He just wants more people to die before he lets it out. So, yeah, it's fucking amazing, folks, that this lady either fucked up or deliberately released this. And when they put the disclaimer, but the fact that a disclaimer written on October 11, 2019, this model was used exclusively for the exercise in October 2019 and does not relate and cannot be applied to the current 2019 nCoV outbreaks because the epidemiology inputs of this model differ from what is observed. So what? They differ because you changed it to cover up the truth. But one lady dated it, whether that was deliberate, whether it was an accident, and or whether they're just dumb thinking, oh, well, we'll just move the name backwards. They won't know, they're stupid. Or they think we're fucking mushrooms and they're trying to feed us bullshit. But the evidence is there, folks. This is the evidence. And you, in about 2 seconds, will all have permission to not only copy this video. I've just got to give the permission. Hang on. Where are we? Standard YouTube license. There we go. Creative Commons. As you can see there, folks, you all now have permission. Oops, where the fuck is it? You all have permission. There it is there. You all now have permission to copy and upload this video to your own channel. Please do it. Please spread the truth. The truth needs to be out there. Too many people have died from this virus, including my friend, family, my family. And they're covering it up. And it's not right. It's not fucking right. These people, now this is where I'm going to go through the names for a couple of minutes. These people need to be investigated and look at their bank accounts. Check their bank accounts out, folks. Latoya D. Abbott. Oh, I'm not going to mention the names because my voice is fucked. Sophia Bergs. I said I'm not going to break Cornet. Sorry, there we go. Timothy Evans. George Fu, Professor George Fu, the Director General of the Chinese Center for Disease Control, the Chinese CDC, the Chinese CDC. Avril Haines, Australians are going to get pissed off with that one. Jane Holton, Australians are going to get pissed off about that guy. Martin, Senior Director, Emergency, Lufthansa Airlines, Germany. The elite. The fucking elite. The elite are part of it, folks. The elite and China are part of it. News Group, the Bloomberg News Group is part of this. This is why they want to control the media. Because they don't want this truth going out. They do not want this truth going out. So please, re-upload this video to your own channels. You have full permission to re-upload this video. My name is Anthony James Avery. And yes, I'm trying to tell the Chinese people to stand up and revolt. And I have been for 2 weeks. I've even told the government they need to fucking support them when they do. And one of my next videos is going to be very old videos of the Chinese fucking revolution, and it most probably will be computerized Chinese going out to the Chinese people on how to fucking stand up to a government. So yeah, Chariot, yeah, I'd be willing to. 100%, 100 fucking percent. Because that's what we're facing. We're facing tyranny. And if I find out my government's involved, fuck yeah. Because this is wrong. This is wrong. Well, like, Australia's death toll's already started re-rising. Our number of cases is already restarting. We've only been reopened 2-3 days, and it's already started. Australia's in its second wave. If you're sick or like me, you need to lock down. The lady with the chooks, I've got some chooks that have been grown and they're coming home. And she had the decency to offer me that she'd bring them down here for me. And so she understands and everything like that. So Australians are working together. But now, we can cripple these arseholes, folks. We can cripple these arseholes that did this because they are the elite. They are affected by their pocket. China is affected by its pocket. Now, one thing we all need to do as well, we all need to ring our governments. Now, in Australia, you ring 62777777. That's 0262777777. So, 6 7s and 62 before it. So, 62777777. And ring our government and tell them that they should ask for the Prime Minister's office, and you will get put through to the Prime Minister's underlings. Trust me, he's got about 50 at the moment in that office. One of the girls was telling me they've got a lot of underlings in that office. His office and the Minister for Health are the two most packed out. And I'm going to confront them by this tomorrow as well. And because I'm also going to confront them about the fact that all the dole people are getting extra money. I'm going to say, well, why the fuck aren't I getting extra fucking money? Because I'm stuck home here. And they're getting $1,500 a week. I'm still only getting the $750 plus what I get for PES for going to college. And I can't buy meat, and yet all these people on the dole are getting fucking meat. They're able to buy meat. I haven't been able to fucking buy meat in ages. I had to borrow money last time I bought meat. And, when one of you guys super chat me. But that still takes month. That takes a month to get that money. That's why I tell everybody just to put it in my PayPal link in my about page. So that way I do get it straight up. But, no, folks, this is fucking wrong. This is way wrong. The fact that the smoking gun evidence is out there. It's been out there the whole time. All I had to do was click on links. That's all I had to do was click on the links. And but the fact that they've put a disclaimer up there. Oh, well, the epidemiology is different. Doesn't mean shit if it's different. All they did was just change the epidemiology. That's all it was. The Chinese is an evil government. China is an evil government, and it needs to be stopped. And if our governments do not, and I'm telling now every American out there that watches this video, you need to contact your government and tell them to confiscate every fucking Chinese-owned company. Because, by the way, folks, if you don't know, Chinese-owned, unless they're fucking American citizens, Chinese, there's a lot of Chinese-owned businesses in America that they're saying, oh, well, you can't investigate us because it's a state secret, so you can't investigate it. Every one of those businesses should be confiscated because, like, we need to do this properly. We do need to take them to court in Australia or America or whatever country you live in. Take them to court, win the case in your country, then confiscate every one of their fucking businesses. Confiscate them. Confiscate them and sell them fucking off to Australians or Americans, whatever. And do not fucking allow these assholes to ever buy a business in our country again. We also need to put massive fucking tariffs on anything coming out of China, including eBay, Alibaba. So yeah, anybody that does what I used to do and buy on Alibaba and sell it for a profit, anybody that does that needs to find a new country. Oh yeah, go to India or to Taiwan. Taiwan will make your products almost just as cheap as China. So go to China, Taiwan to get your products, folks. Taiwanese products actually last a hell of a lot fucking longer than the Chinese one. Like, why buy fucking Chinese anyhow? Every time I bought something made in fucking China, a good example is my shoes. If my fucking video was working, I'd fucking show you my boot. Brand new pair of boots, only most probably a month old, and the soles split apart. I had to glue them together yesterday so I could at least get a couple more days out of them. Nearly everything I buy that comes from China breaks. Everything. Why? Because they want you to buy more. Ah, well, it's cheap. They'll buy more. Well, stop buying the cheap shit, folks. Stop buying their cheap shit. Stop buying it. Because buying their cheap shit only encourages them to fucking keep on doing this. And by doing this, it's, yeah. Yeah, there we go. I'll just fix the problem in the title above. And so the whole point is, folks, that when this came out, it was hidden from us for months. They didn't tell us about it. China didn't tell the world about it. And yeah, I do believe some governments were deceived, but there are some people within those governments that fucking know about this shit. I reckon every politician, and I'm saying this, every politician should be checked for money coming from China. It should now be made a standard compulsory thing. So if you, whatever country you are in, you should call for a finding that any politician that has accepted money from China, their bank accounts should be scrutinized heavily. And because I reckon we're going to find moles within our own. Well, we already know they've tried to infiltrate Australia. We know they've tried to infiltrate the American government. But there's still, what about those politicians they didn't know about? So, yeah, we've got a lot of work ahead of us, folks. So who, why, when? Now we know for a fact. We know that who, why, and when. And it was, China was involved. As I said, I've shown you his picture. He's there. The director of the fucking CDC in China. The Chinese CDC knows all about it. And Buster just put up evidence of the American CDC. So they're involved in this as well. I'd say every one of those people high up in the CDC or someone even low, everybody in the CDC in no matter what country, check their bank accounts. Check their bank accounts. Any money coming from China or China Bank, every transfer from, and I reckon it's going to be one of the biggest tasks that we need to do. Just like when they were tracking down the Nazis, we need to track down the, I'm going to call them fucking China Nazis or the CCP Nazis. the CCP Nazis should be tracked down, because if they don't come from China, they're a CCP Nazi, because if they've taken money from China to influence Wall Street, and this has happened, there's a lot of Wall Street people that need to go to fucking jail because they were the ones that allow China to come in. Because, see, they had this scenario, well, if we let China grow, well, they will eventually start democracy. Well, where's the fucking democracy? Look what they're doing to fucking Hong Kong, for fuck's sake. Look what they are fucking doing to Hong Kong. Look what they're doing to the Falun Gong movement. They're fucking harvesting their organs. This needs to be stopped, and it needs to be stopped now. And if you are Chinese and can understand fucking English, stand up to your government, for fuck's sake, and remove the bastards. Yes, you're gonna have to have a civil fucking war. You need to remove that arsehole. You need to remove the fucking CCP, the dragon. You need to remove it. Maybe that is the dragon that was mentioned in the fucking Bible. You never think of that. It could be the dragon that was mentioned in the Bible. But here it is, folks. As you can see, the evidence connecting the virus to Event 201 is clear as day. It's right in front of your eyes right now. As I said, my name is Anthony James Avery, also known as Bluebeard the Cannabis Protester and many 2017, and many other names out there on the web. Because I accept most of my other sites, I use my own name. But one thing I can't stand is corruption. Another thing I can't stand is fucking dictators. And the other thing that I can't stand is some cunt that's trying to kill me here. And I'm sorry for swearing, but it deserved to be said that these assholes need to be held accountable. And collaborators, that's what they're called. I've been trying to think of that word for ages. The collaborators with the CCP that planned this virus in Event 201 need to be held accountable, and their bank accounts need to be looked at very seriously. Need to be looked at. And look at the subsidiary. If they've had any big deposits, look at the subsidiaries where they're getting the money from. Because they may use a third-party company to transfer the money. They may have transferred it to one company, then transferred it to another. This is generally how criminals work. They don't do it directly. They never do it directly. Look at their bank accounts. Look at all the bank, and look, especially look at that woman from fucking ANZ Bank. She should be removed from the board of directors of the ANZ Bank and sent to fucking jail. Why in the fuck was she in the meeting anyhow? That's what gets me. Why in the fuck was she in the meeting? And I'm sorry, folks, that I haven't been responding to chat as much as I normally do. But we need to do something about this, folks. We really do. We truly do need it. As I said, there is the evidence in front of you. If you can't see that in front of your eyes, you're a fucking idiot. So wake the fuck up! And realize that this is a plandemic, not a pandemic. The evidence is looking you right in the fucking eyes in the form of a disclaimer saying, oh, in no way is this connected to the virus in 2019. They're giving that, saying the virus started in 2019. And it dated in October 11, 2019. So if you still think this is a fucking conspiracy, you are a fucking moron. You are dead set a fucking moron if you think this is a conspiracy. Not a conspiracy, folks. This is real. There's the fucking evidence right in front of your fucking eyes right fucking now. Look at it. Read it. I put the link in the chat. It's in the description. Go and read these things. And I'm going to say thank you to all my moderators and to everybody that came on. Spooky Cat, Rick Does Chung and Guitar, Loyalty, Buster, Chariot of Faith, Spooky Cat, DJ195. And DJ195, be careful with your comments. Otherwise, they get blocked by YouTube, and then eventually they get blocked by fucking one of my moderators, which what happened to you. So be careful, okay? Everybody out there, this is not over yet. This is not over. So please, social distance, wear a mask. And it, by the way, at the moment, like, oh, something else. I went to the doctor, yes, before I go, I went to the doctor's yesterday. And it's already been said in our country that if you've got a cough, wear a mask. Fucking three people, they go, ahem, ahem. Not wearing a fucking mask. Not one of them. Not wearing a fucking mask. Thank God I was. And trust me, I was wearing a full fucking face shield N100 fucking mask. And if I had the money, I would pay for the fucking breathing apparatus that attaches to it and pumps me fresh, clean fucking air through a N1. I think it's an N. They're classified as an N200 or something, where it filters every fucking thing. Fumes, gas, the whole fucking lot of proper gas masks. Nothing gets through that one. But it's got to be pumped. The air's got to be pumped to you. Same one that they wear in hospitals. If I had that money, which is $2,000, that I don't have that money, but I already had that mask, and I just had to spend $37 on N100 filters. But yeah, please, for fuck's sake, wear a mask. If you've got a cough, wear a fucking mask. Oh, you're a fucking idiot if you don't. And I'm not saying it's right that all these people that are harassing people that aren't wearing masks in America, because we should be fucking harassing people that aren't wearing masks here in Australia. Fuck. We really should. One quick little message to single mothers out there. If you take your kid out fucking side while this virus is still out there, and yes, it's still fucking out there. Yes, they've relaxed the restrictions. If you take your kid outside or send him to school, you are a fucking even bigger moron. So, look, I love you all. And please spread this video. Copy it and please paste it on your own website. You will not get a copyright strike, because I have put Creative Commons on the video. I have even put it up in the video so that people can see that it is a Creative Commons video. You have every legal right to copy this video and put it on your own channel. Please still give me credit. Copy the description, at least the first part of the description, and throw my name that I made the video. It would be greatly appreciated. And please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. And when you're doing that, now where the fuck is it? Sorry. I've lost something here. I always lose it. Please don't forget to click that little bell down the bottom, because if you don't click that little bell, you won't get notified. Oh, and before I go, has anybody else come across the fact that you're getting notifications to videos that have been out and you've already watched a day before, but you're now getting the notification a day later that they just put a video out? Anybody else going through that? Fucking YouTube's fucked. I love you all. Stay safe. And yeah, wear a fucking mask. And social fucking distance. This is real, folks. You will fucking stand a chance of dying. You've only got to have fucking asthma and you could die. So yeah. Don't take any fucking chances. Be smart and don't be a moron.